All right, this is it. Yeah, I'm not gonna do a traditional album review this time.
Roger, we'll stop Discovery.
Day.
A great ending to the new beginning.
And a review. Encore by DJ Snake. Yeah, so where do I start? So this is my favorite album of all time. I just want to say that right off the bat. Yeah. So I'm gonna get into why that is in a sec, but so little backstory here. Before I get into the actual review, this truly fantastic, perfect, immensely powerful album that DJ Snake crafted. But today is the 5 year, by the time this video releases, this will be the 5 year anniversary of this album. And so 5 years ago, man. So I'll give you a little story of why, of what happened before this album came out. So in 2013, I was going through a rough time in my life. Like, a very rough time. My parents were getting divorced. Things were rough. I was very alone. My grandma just died. I was very depressed. I started a new school with no friends. I didn't know anybody yet. I got expelled from my old school and switched schools. 2013 was a really dark time in my life, I'll admit. And I'll get to the album, like I said, I'll get to the album second. I'm telling you all what's the backstory before I go into this. But so, like I said, 2013 was a very dark time. So, it was the end of the year in 2013, December. I was walking home from school. So, this was like my first semester of my new school. I was almost done. It was a rough time. I was starting to make friends. Things were starting to get better. But I was still kind of having a tough time. Like, there wasn't much going in my life. And then this song came on. So, basically, I was walking home from school. And turned down for what was being played at full blast from this car. That was the day. Honestly, well, the first time I heard that song, it was like nothing I ever heard before. It was truly, I remember when that car blew by me and that song was playing, I was like, what is this? Like, at first, Turned Up for What was the first song I ever heard from DJ Snake. Most people, but I had no idea how much, how deep it would go from that point on. Like, yeah, that was just the beginning. So Turn Down for What was a hit. It was a giant hit of 2014 when that song came out. After it came out, it was one of the biggest songs of all time. Rightfully so, that song is fucking perfect. It's just like, it is one of my most favorite songs of all time. And DJ Snake went from being this, like, he made a couple songs before that, though. I went into more depth. He made Burr Machine together, which are also phenomenal songs. Burr Machine was a pretty big song, but it wasn't as big as Turn Down for What, obviously. Turn Down for What kind of was the song that took a small-town DJ, like someone that wasn't well-known, and boosted him to absolute fame. That one song had that power to do so. It went from, I mean, that song just created an entire, like, inspirational genre of things. It did things. I know I'm over. I know what to say. Just Turn Down for What.
Well, I mean, it's a really iconic song for many freaking reasons.
So, after that, I wanted to just, I was, like, DJ Snake, like, Little John was good, but DJ Snake really inspired me with that song. He was like, man, this is truly something one of a kind. Like, I mean, the fact that you didn't need lyrics to make a great song, you just needed the music. So, after that, he released Get Low, which Get Low with Dylan Francis is really good, I'll admit. I like Get Low a lot. I know it's not one of the best DJ Snake songs, but it's a really good song. I like it. And they played it in Furious 7. So, yeah, I just realized I completely forgot to mention Lean On with Major Lazer. Yeah, I kind of realized that rewatching and editing this. Yeah, I completely forgot to mention Lean On. But yes, Lean On is a legendary song as well, obviously. That's one of my favorite songs of all time. That was after You Know You Like It, but before the album. I kind of forgot to mention that during this video, so I just want to mention that briefly before we continue. Yes, Lean On's also legendary. It's one of the best songs I've ever made. So, yeah, I just want to say that real quick. But I was always hyped. After Turned Out for What came out, I was always hyped to see what he would do next. So his follow-up to Turned Down for What. How does he follow it up? How do you follow a song like Turned Down for What? That was the question. How do you follow it up? Well, the answer was simple. You just released the best song of all time. You know you like it.
Some people want me to be heads or tails. I say no way, try again another day. I should be happy, not tipping the scales. I just won't play, letting my life get away. I know for me, I'm not a follower. I don't take things as they come, if they bring me down. Life can be cruel, if you're a dreamer. I just wanna have some fun, don't tell me what could be done. You know you like it, but it drives you insane. You know you like it, but it drives you insane.
Somehow, you know, when You Know How You Like It came out, when that music video came out, I was like, finally, I get a new DJ Snake song. But I had no idea how good it was going to be. Like, I thought it was just going to be like Turned Down for What? I thought it was going to be a nice jammy song. Not what that was. Like, You Know You Like It was a song I became a true, undivided fan to DJ Snake. That was the song. I was like, this dude is beyond. Like, this dude is like something. I mean, bro. I remember when I finished the You Know You Like It music video the first time, I was just sitting there like, what? Like, whoa, what? I couldn't even believe what I just listened to and watched. I was just like, wow, like, this is unbelievable. He somehow top Turned Down for What, which I didn't think he could even do. Like, that was just insane. But, okay, so from that point on, I went on to become the ultimate DJ Snake fan. Nobody, and I'm saying nobody, is a bigger fan of DJ Snake than I am. This is just the truth. Like, nobody is going to be. Because, like, every song, everything that this guy makes is powerful shit. I have not listened to one bad song from this dude yet. I am just blown impressed with what he does. So the hype for his first album could not be more real. After You Know You Like It, his first album became my most hype album of all time. I was, like, digging to see when he would release it. I was, every day, like, from You Know You Like It, I just was so hyped for his first album. I just could not believe. I was, like, I was a bigger fan of him, and I still am. I'm just, bro, like, let me tell you. Like, every day since You Know You Like It, I was digging. I was like, when is it coming out? When is it coming out? He released a single, like, the first single for it was Middle, and Middle was perfect, a perfect lead single. And then he just kept releasing more stuff. But he never gave a release date. He would never give a release date for when it was coming out. He would just release single after single. We wouldn't get a release date. So I was just like, ugh, come on, like, give me a release date. So years went by after You Know You Like It came out in 2014. Years went by, 2 years. I was just, come on, like, when is it? Come on, man. Like, this is the most hype. You guys understand, no hype album was reaching the hype to this first album. Like, I was beyond hype for his first album. Like, those first two songs just sold me. I'm like, this dude is gonna craft something truly immense. So, I mean, that's like, I didn't listen before Encore. I didn't listen to a lot of albums, guys. Like, I only listened to, like, a couple albums before that. Like, I listened to Meteora by Linkin Park. Meteora by Linkin Park was my favorite album of all time for a while. I listened to Mad Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy. I was a Kanye fan. Not now, I'm a much bigger Kanye fan, but I was always a Kanye fan. He just wasn't my favorite rapper. Now he is. But, okay, so I've only, like I said, before Encore, I didn't listen to a lot of albums. Like, it was mostly a couple things. I wasn't a big album listener. Yeah, I listened to Eminem albums. I listened to Kanye stuff. I listened to Linkin Park, but that was it. I wasn't big on checking out new albums before Encore came out. So, at long last, in 2016, a month after Encore came out. Now, I didn't know Encore came out originally. When it came out, I didn't know, because I just kind of gave up at that point. I was just like, well, whatever, I'll just wait when it comes out. Whenever it comes out. Because he would never give an official release date for it. He would just, like, tease us, but he wouldn't give us the release date. So I'm just like, whatever, alright, I'll just give up trying to figure out when it's coming out, because you're just not going to give a release date. But at long last, in what was it, September, I think? September 2016 finally came along, and I found out, one of my friends told me, Tate, DJ Tanake's album is out. I'm like, are you serious? Are you being for real? Is it out? And he's like, yes. So as soon as he said that, I went straight to Target to get the Target Deluxe of this album, of Encore. Like, in fact, I still have it. As I was saying, as soon as he said that, I went to Target, because there was a Target exclusive bonus disc that had two extra songs on it. I wanted to get all of them. So I went to Target, and I got Encore. The first album I ever bought, by the way. This is a piece of history right here, when I bought this. So, yeah, I popped it in. Let me tell you what. I kind of wish I recorded my reactions to this album the first time, because, wow. Without further ado, let me review DJ Snake's Encore. So, we start out with intro, which I've already played already. Intro/AA6. I don't really need to play the songs, because I've pretty much memorized them. I've listened to this album approximately 30-40 times, guys. I think I've listened to Encore more than most. Like, it is my favorite album of all time. I've listened to Encore more times than I can count. It is the most appropriate title, I think, an album has. It really is an encore. You just don't want to stop playing it over and over again. Like, anyway, but so. And also, just this cover is just iconic shit. Like, this is my favorite album of cover of all time. Just him walking up to this metropolitan subway in the desert in the Sahara, which one of the songs is called Sahara. But yeah, so we got intro, which is an excellent intro track. It's not the best intro track ever, but it is certainly great setup. AA6 is like, all right, before I continue, I just want to say I will briefly cover the two bonus tracks on the Target edition, but I'm mostly going to be talking about the main tracks, because that, even without the two bonus tracks, those are kind of like an epilogue. You don't need those two. But yeah, I mean, I'll cover those briefly, because you can't really play them on Apple Music. You can only, I think they don't even sell this copy anymore. I was lucky enough to get this copy. But yeah, I mean, you can't really just get it. You have to buy it online or something. I don't think they sell it anymore. You can't just stream it. You have to get it. I was lucky enough to get the Target edition when it came out, but yeah. So anyway, this is intro A6. I already played a little bit of it, but for the, yeah. Yeah, I'm only going to briefly play them, because I don't need to play a lot for them most of the time. But I remember when I first heard AA6, I'm just like intro AA6, I'm just like, I'm in for a treat. Like, already you got me hooked in. I was like, dang, like, that was one hell of an intro. Like, it just completely set the tone right away, what you were going to get. And then we get the lead single of the album, which is Middle, featuring Bipolar Sunshine. I don't get why Bipolar Sunshine wasn't on Cardi Blanche. I mean, even though, like, he's on two songs on this album. He's a really excellent singer. He's not the best singer of DJ Snake's collaborators, but he's a really good singer. I hope he comes back for the third album. I am excited to see what Bipolar drops. He's a very good singer. I hope that he makes an album. I listened to some of his pieces. It's pretty good. But anyway, back to Middle. So, Middle was the lead single. And it's definitely one of my favorite DJ Snake songs. The lyrics are just phenomenal. The background music is just phenomenal. Bipolar kills it with the singing. I mean, anyway, I'll just play it again. Staring at you. Alright. Every song DJ Snake seems to make has this epic, grand feel to it. Like, Middle is just... staring at two different... Let me just read the lyrics. And your coffee is gone cold, it's like time for... I mean, I related to this song a lot because I always felt like I was causing problems and I needed to sweep things under the carpet. Like, turn back time to make it all right. It's just beautiful fucking music, man. I would go as far to say DJ Snake is the Mozart of the modern times. Like, he is truly a passionate, beautiful musician that just doesn't take a break. He just gives it 101. I mean, every song you listen to DJ Snake, it is just epic. Like, I don't know. For real. Middle's no exception. It's one of the best songs from him. I wouldn't say it's the best on this album. I'd probably say it's like 2 or 3. It's up there. Middle's iconic. It's the first single from this album. So, yeah. Pretty amazing. I've already covered Middle enough. You've seen me play it in videos and stuff back then, so I'm going to move on. So, what I was really excited for was Sahara, because this is the third track. This is featuring Skrillex, and Skrillex is known as the king of dubstep. I've always wondered, like, what a Skrillex DJ Snake song would sound like. So far, this is the only song they made together. But let me tell you, this is easily the best song I've ever heard from Skrillex. Like, Sahara is badass. Here we go. So this is Sahara. Right off the bat, you're just like, whoa. I mean, it's like, I mean, I love how DJ Snake, he has this thing where he just builds up to something grand in the middle of the song. Like, you know you're gonna get something insane. I think what makes Sahara special is that DJ Snake is so light and so ground to earth, and Skrillex is all crazy, out there, intense. So I think they blended extremely well together on this song. Like, you feel Skrillex and you feel DJ Snake both on here. That's what makes it good. So, I mean, it really makes you feel like you're in the desert. But I'll just skip to the Skrillex part. So, it is truly a headbanger. Whew. Yeah, Sahara is just also phenomenal. No shit. Every song on here is phenomenal. Like, bruh, it's freaking Encore. Like, yeah. I think what just makes some of these songs special is they don't even need lyrics to be phenomenal. Like, it's just extremely well-crafted music. They don't need lyrics. Like,
they're just extremely well-crafted music.
Like, Zahara was just boss. I mean, I'm just gonna be talking about each song a lot, because all these songs mean a lot to me, guys. Like, every song on Encore is just phenomenal. Either 9 out of 10 or 10 out of 10. They're just all phenomenal songs. Like, for real. I mean, I can't gripe. Like, I mean, yeah, Sahara is just boss. You feel like you're in the desert. It has an excellent Skrillex. Like, they blend perfectly together. The instrumentals are epic and grand in scale. It's just amazing. It's just amazing. So, alright. I'll move on to track, what is it? Track, 4. Sober, with J-Rai. I don't know J-Rai that well. I think he's... I never actually went to go listen to songs, but Sober's an excellent song. So, this is Sober. What makes the album truly special is that for I mean, just the way DJ Snake organizes it. Like, we get the nice middle, then the intense Sahara, then the nice Sober, then the intense Begal, then the nice Talk. Like, it goes back and forth. It goes from, for the first half of this album, it goes back and forth up until the half, but which is the start of the second half, ironically called the half, but exactly, like the way DJ Snake organized this, it is the best track organization of any album. Like the way he organized it, it wasn't just the songs themselves, but the way he put it was like slow, flawlessly done. I would have not put them any of the songs any other way than the way they are. Like, he organized this track list extremely well. It's unreal how he did it. Like, for real. I just am impressed with it a lot. Sober is excellent. Has excellent lyrics. When I'm thinking with you, feels like time is moving slower. I realize you never call me when you're sober. J-Rai has excellent vocals. He gives it 110. Alright, so I just want to pause here real quick and say, apparently J-Rai is short for J. Ryan. This is a little fun fact. Apparently he's on Fireball with Pitbull. I didn't know these were the same people. Like, J-Rai is John Ryan. That's what it, and the initials mean. So I had no idea. I just wanted to point that out before we continue. That's a pretty cool factoid. I had no idea. So that just made that song way more better. But yeah, it's pretty cool that John Ryan, aka J-Rai, was on this album. And then we get to the Tell Me One More. Da-na-na-na. Here we go. I mean, geez, like, DJ Snake just knows how to choose these people that aren't that well known and just make them extremely amazing people. Like, he makes me listen to people I would have never listened to before. Because he just takes these, like, I would have never checked out Bipolar, J-Rai, or Gashi if it weren't for DJ Snake. Like, he doesn't need famous people to make excellent music. That's what makes DJ Snake so incredible. He can take complete nobodies, complete people that don't matter, and just make them amazing. Like, his status alone can get people to listen to music. That's why one day I hope to be on a DJ Snake album. Because, I mean, literally, like, so many of these people I've listened to now because of DJ Snake. Like, okay, there's a couple I haven't listened to yet, but still, like, oh yeah, Jay Sober's fantastic. Amazing instrumentals, beautiful to the ears, incredible lyrics, incredible vocals. Like, you're just gonna hear me say this every time. Anyway, I'm gonna move on. Okay, track number 5, Begal. So, but Moski.
Yeah, here we go.
Like, bro, I legit don't understand how anybody could possibly listen to this album and say, oh yeah, I don't like it. It's impossible. You're not gonna say that. Like, this album literally has everything. Like, it has every single, like, thing anybody could possibly like on it. Like, even if you dislike one song, there's gonna be another song you like. Like, trust me when I say there is not a single song on here that isn't good. Like, they're all good, at least. Over good. I don't know how it'd even be possible for someone to say they don't like this. Like, legit! Like, how would you say that? I wanna know! I've never met a single person in my life that's listened to this and say, oh yeah, it's not that good. You're not gonna say that. It's literally impossible! Okay, anyway. But yeah, because, like, it's truly phenomenal. I mean, the doom, like, the way he times everything, like, DJ Snake has such this timing to him. Like, he can time the vocals and the beats and the instruments so perfectly. So, to a T. I don't know how he does it. The timing on his songs are so good. Like, and there's the main part.
We are the fucking dancer!
Drop it. Badass. Bring it back now. It's like the most jammy ass shit, like, bro. I don't know, man. Like, Big All's phenomenal. I mean, no shit. They're all phenomenal. Like, I know, okay, certain songs on here may be a little abrasive to the ears if you're not used to this type of sound. That is one thing I might say maybe you want, might like certain songs like Pagal, Ocho Cinco, and Sahara. Those are the hardest songs on here. The rest are pretty light or rappy. So, those three songs you might not like, I guess. They're a lot more intense, a lot more out there. But they're just so unique. There's nothing like these songs on the Encore. There's nothing like them. I mean, legit. I've tried to find songs. Even Cardi Blanchi felt like a completely different album than this. Like, Encore is just one of a kind. There is nothing like it. DJ Snake has such a uniqueness for making music. Every song he makes, even though it's similar, it always feels like a different new thing. He's a visionary. Really. I don't know how he does it. Then anyway, let's move on to talk, so, with George Maple. I don't know George Maple that well, I still haven't checked him out yet, but Talk is one of the, well, this was one of the lead singles with, Middle and I think, The Half, I think was one of the lead singles. Either, I have to look up what the lead singles were again. Oh, hold on. Alright, yeah, so the lead singles were Middle, Talk, Let Me Love You, obviously, and The Half. Those were the four lead singles. Talk was the second lead single. I really liked this when it came out, but hearing it on the album was way better, like, honestly. Just having those other songs before just made Talk a 10 times better of a song. Here it is. So this is Talk. Like I said, the placement of these songs are truly phenomenal. Like, I can't get over how it's a masterpiece. I mean, for real. This is definitely the lightest song on here. It's just definitely great, you know. Touch your skin, my vision. Seeing the same feeling. Yeah, George Maple's voice is phenomenal. The lyrics are phenomenal. The instrumental is phenomenal. I haven't really listened to George Maple all the way. I'm gonna check her. Is it a girl? It's just weird. Like, why is her name George Maple? I guess it's just her stage name. Yeah, she's a phenomenal singer. I hope she comes back for another DJ Snake album. She wasn't on Cardi Blanche, unfortunately, but she just killed this song. Talk is phenomenal, writing-wise. DJ Snake, writing-wise. Every lyric he writes, such a finesse to it. Such a power to it. And then Turned Down for What? He took the lyrics. Turned Down for What? You know, just two lines. And then for You Know How You Like It. Well, granted, You Know How You Like It's technically a remix. But lyrically, that song's phenomenal, too. That's the Luna George wrote the lyrics. But I'm just saying, every lyric, like, every song DJ Snake makes, it feels like he just has a respect for the art. Like, he understands that music is more than just, you know, a fun thing. It's meant to be a piece of art. And, yeah. Every song he makes feels like a piece of art. He respects this. He respects music more than any person I think I've ever seen or listened to. Like, yeah. So, again, Talk is phenomenal. It has great lyrics, great message about, you know, sometimes you just talk. All you want to do is talk, you know. I mean, it's relatable songs. Like, okay. Anyway. So now we move on to track 7, which is the end of the first half. Act 1 of the album. Act 2 is a lot different. But Ultra Single is the end of the first half. This is with Yellow Claw. Yellow Claw is very good. I don't think they're as good as DJ Snake, obviously. But, so here we go. We got Ocho Cinco with Yellow Claw. Ready? It's definitely the jammiest song on here because Yellow Claw's on it, but yeah, this is more jammy than both Pagal and Sahara. Oh! I'm just gonna play most of it. Here we go.
DJ Snake and Yellow Motherfucker Crop.
Ocho Cinco. Whew. That's the most hype-ass song of all time. Like, it's just an insolent adrenaline boost. Like, dang. I'll put silent on. But yeah, I mean, it's just the instrumentals are bombastic. Yellow Claw just is just going insane. Like, you motherfucking claw, you know. Judas Snake's like. They went ham on this one, like, I honestly. My favorite part's the ending part, though. Like, the last part of this song is, like, awesome. So. Let's get to that part. Ocho Cinco! Alright. Here it comes. Here it comes. Ready? Like, man. That song did not have to go that hard. Like, I think Ocho Cinco might be as cool as turned out for what is. Like, definitely better than Get Low. I fall more in love with Ocho Cinco. For a while, Ocho Cinco and Oh Me Oh My were my least favorite tracks. But over time, they've really, like, grown on me a ton. Like, they're pretty awesome. Like, yeah. I love this song. Definitely my favorite Yellow Claw song, clearly. But yeah. You're gonna hear me say that a lot. Alright, so now we made it to the halfway mark. So what does that mean? We're in the half of the album. So I guess that means it's time for the half. With so this was a track I was extremely hyped for when it was coming out. So, to give you a little idea who's on this track, so the half is DJ Snake, but it also features Jeremiah, Young Thug, and Swiss Beatz. Honestly, I think my most hyped tracks when this album was coming out was the half, and Here Comes the Night, probably. Although, I was, of course, Sahara, but Here Comes the Night is the ending track, so of course I was hyped for that, and Mr. Hudson's pretty well known. Kind of. I didn't know him that much before his album. Like I said, I wasn't that known to music. But, so yeah, the half. Definitely one of the most badass songs ever made. The half is, okay, I'm just gonna play it.
It's a Friday, I'm about to go off.
Here's Swiss Beatz. He did go off. Look, that's all I'm going to play, because you've probably heard that already, but Swiss Beatz is pretty one-on. Having DJ Snake and Swiss Beatz and Jeremiah, and having all these people on one song was just amazing. This is probably still my favorite Young Thug verse of all time. His verse on this is iconic shit, and I just, man, like, everybody did so well on the half. Like, it just is, like, one of the best collab songs ever fucking made. Like, for real. It's definitely better. I still think the half is better than both. What was the ones that Carte Blanche had? Talky Talky and, look. Ocho. Fuck. What's it called? Enzo, yeah. Enzo and Talky Talky are really good songs, but they're not the half.
Like, they're just not, okay? Like,
the way that they did the half was just so phenomenal. The music video is phenomenal. Jeremiah's voice is phenomenal. Young Thug's verse is perfect. Swiss Beatz just adds a funky thing to it. It is just amazing. Like, God. I listened to the half so many times that I just cannot get over how incredible of a song it is. I mean, as a rap song, I wouldn't say it's amazing, but it's just as a song. Like, as a piece of music, the half is just a perfect midway to this album. And it just sets up the second half of this album beautifully. Like I said, I just love how DJ Snake placed the songs on this album. He just placed them perfectly. And yeah, the half is iconic. Probably my third favorite. My first would be Here Comes the Night. I'll get to that later. But Here Comes the Night, middle, and then the half. Those are my three favorites on here. Yes, I love the half more than Let Me Love You. I'll get to that in a sec. But yeah. Then we got Oh Me Oh My, which, this song grown on me a lot. This used to be my least favorite on here, but it has grown on me a ton, so. This has also a bunch of other people on it, another rap song. It has Travis Scott, Migos, and Gashi all on one song. This is the first time I ever heard Gashi. I heard Migos and Travis Scott before this, obviously, but yeah. I was introduced to Gashi thanks to this album. I love Gashi to death now, but yeah. He's definitely a best, he's the best friend of DJ Snake. They're frequent collaborators. Just like me and my friend Mark are frequent collaborators. MTS the Shark, aka MGD. But yeah, Oh Me Oh My. Oh Me Oh My. I still think the Half and Oh Me Oh My are still better than Enzo. Enzo, I feel, is like DJ Snake's weakest rap song. It's still really good, but it's definitely his weakest rap song he's made. Like, of all the rap songs DJ Snake has produced, Enzo's definitely the weakest. That's one of the reasons I wasn't that hyped for Cardi Blanche. I know, I'm not talking about Cardi Blanche, but yeah, Oh Me Oh My is just a really great song. Woo! That's Gashi. Woo!
Hey, oh me. Oh me, oh my. I just shut the club down, I ain't even try. I ain't gonna find anything, any ride or die. And we guarantee we let it fly.
I think the reason this is a weaker track on it, it's still a great song, but it's a weaker track just for the fact that it's less of a DJ Snake song and more of a Migos Travis Scott song, which is fine if you're a big fan of them. But it just feels like more DJ Snake produced it than actually worked on it. It definitely feels less of his song. I know that's something negative. It's still, like I said, it's still a phenomenal song. DJ Snake did a wonderful job with it, organizing it, and getting those people on there. I don't know how he, I still don't get how he got these people on here. Like, he wasn't that big at the time. Like, all he made was turn over one, you know, you like it. Like, it wasn't like he was a big person. I don't know how he got these people out here. Now, granted, he did work with Lady Gaga a little bit before, too, so okay. But still, like, I just don't get how he got these people out here. Like, I guess he has connections because of Little John, maybe. I don't know, but yeah, Oh Me Oh My is awesome. Has great lyrics. Yeah, it's a pretty badass song. It's not as good as The Half. And it's not as good as For Life, but yeah, it's a great song. So then we got another jammy song, Propaganda. So fun fact, Propaganda is one of the only two songs on this thing, not counting the bonus track. Technically, yeah, I think Propaganda is the only song on the main track list that is just DJ Snake, just him. So that's what makes Propaganda really cool. It's just him doing this. So now, luckily, Cardi Blanche had a lot more of him just doing the songs, but Propaganda was a cool. The only other song he made that was just him before Propaganda was Together, and that was, like, before Turn Down For What came out. But yeah, DJ Snake always had someone else
there to help him out.
So I was very interested to see how Propaganda would sound. I'm like, wait a minute, a solo DJ Snake song? Like, how's that gonna work? Well, I was impressed. This is pretty fucking cool. You know. I want to know the process. Like, I always wonder how he makes this music. Like, I know he has a soundboard, but like I said, DJ Snake songs are truly one of a kind. Like, I don't understand the process of how he does this shit. Like, I just want to know. Like, can you show me how you do this? Like, yeah, I'll just keep building and building and building. I just like how he takes breaks. Like, and then he goes back up, he's like, dun, 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 here we go. I especially recommend you listen to Encore in headphones. It is awesome as shit to listen with it with headphones. But, I mean, it's amazing no matter how you play it. But I just feel like with headphones, it's a lot better. You get way more into it. I mean, that's the thing. DJ Snake songs just kind of feel like you're in, like, the song. It is a weird experience to listen to a DJ Snake album. Like, it's kind of like you get transported. I don't know. I can't explain the feeling of listening to a DJ Snake album. You're just not even in the real world. You've been transported to the astral plane of DJ Snake land. And that's basically what it's like to listen to a DJ Snake album. I'm not even joking. Like, I let my spirit leave my body when I'm listening to these songs. I'm floating in DJ Snake's space dimension.
I don't know, man.
Like, alright, let's keep going. Woo! Adrenaline rush again. Now, I think Propaganda's, it's on par with Ultra Cinco. But yeah, it's a great song. Truly great. Propaganda's the final jammy song, like, really intense one. The rest are light or rap. or, you know. Yeah. Anyway, I'm going to move on. So, track number 11, For Life, with Gashi. So, Gashi and Mr. DJ Snake are frequent collaborators. They're pretty close friends in real life. I think they're best friends, but... yeah, they have a close relationship. I wish we'd get a whole album of them. That would be freaking sick. Like, one, like, you know, Mad Villainy. Well, like, with... I haven't heard Mad Villainy yet. Or one like, you know, Alchemist and the other guy, you know, or the two Savage Mode ones. Like, that'd be cool if we had a whole Gashi DJ Snake, like, mixtape or album, like a project. That'd be kind of amazing. I would love to hear that. Like, because all the songs they made together have truly been some of their best work, like, honestly. Especially on Carte Blanche. But For Life is definitely the weakest Gashi DJ Snake song, but it's still very good. Like, you know. I mean, between For Life and Omi Omai, I don't know which one's better. They're about the same. They're definitely the two weaker ones, but again, they're just really, they're still really great. Yeah, this is For Life. I've got for nothing, ain't that something? Look what I've been through. Honestly, this is a really well-written song, because it just shows DJ Snake's progress. Like, you can really feel DJ Snake in these lyrics. Like, here you go. I came from nothing. Alright, come on.
I'm nothing, ain't that something, look what I've been through. And now I'm out here.
I mean, yeah, this is like a perfect summary of this album. Like, he got his friends, all his collaborators on the album. Because I want this for life, like he wants to keep making music and albums and putting out content. I'm feeding all night, look at my... Like, this, Joshy and DJ Snake put a lot of passion into this song. You can feel it. I mean, you get the point. Do I even need to... look. I mean, seriously, like... even the weakest songs on Encore just feel amazing. Like, it's hard to come up with any negatives for this album. Like, I mean, I know objectively people might not agree with what I'm saying here, but, like, every song just feels personally connected to me on a spiritual level. Like, it's just kind of like, I mean, really, I don't know. It's just amazing. So, yeah, I'm going to move on. You get the point. So, all right, so we got, next one, track 12, Future Part 2. So, this one's pretty amazing. This is the second Bipolar Sunshine song. I didn't know there was a Future Part 1. I don't know why it's called Future Part 2. I think because it's... maybe Bipolar made a song called Future before this? I don't know. I think it's just an entendre. Like, it means, like, the future but Part 2. Like, there's going to be more to the future. I guess that's what it means. I don't know. But it's still an excellent song. Like, here we go. Here we go.
All night long. My future looks brighter in your eyes. So if I ever realize, don't blame the fire, you're mine.
And we go all night long. The fun times through the day. My future looks brighter in your eyes.
Yeah, I mean, look. What? I think I've said enough. Like, jeez. It's heavenly, really. This whole album is heavenly. Beautiful shit. I mean, beautiful, epic, amazing crap. Awesome, dope shit. Like, amazing music. Yep. I mean, bruh. DJ Snake's Nile is like, how can any DJ get close to this shit? Like, he's the ultimate DJ. There is, like, look, Calvin Harris, David Goode, all these other people, Daft Punk. I love Daft Punk. Don't get me wrong. Daft Punk's almost on par with him. Okay, what other DJs are there? Alchemist, DJ Premier, well, we'll get to later. Pharrell, there's a lot of great producers. Okay, I'm not saying there's a lot of good music producers, but... I mean, just Future Part 2 alone, like... For real. No producer, no music producer has done the shit DJ Snake has done. I don't even understand it. Like... It doesn't even sound like traditional music. It's just, what is it? I can't understand. Like, really think about it. Like,
I mean,
I don't know how he does it. I want to know the process here. Like, for real. Like, look, I'm just saying, like, there's nobody quite like DJ Snake. Like, just Future Part 2. Lyrics, amazing. Voice from Valley of Polar Sunshine, perfect. Timing of each beat and sound and rhythm, perfect. It's like harmonized. How is he doing this? I don't get it. Okay. Future Part 2 is amazing, 10 out of 10 song. But anyway, so we got two more to cover. So this is the third single. This is the biggest song from the album. It's called Let Me Love You with Justin Bieber. I'm pretty sure everybody in the fucking world's heard this by now. If you haven't, I'm not even going to play it because you already know what it is. It's Let Me Love You. I mean, Let Me Love You. Personally, I don't know if it's my favorite Justin Bieber song ever. But maybe. I mean, it's up there with this one from Purpose. What Do You Mean? Those are just two best songs. Let Me Love You and What Do You Mean? Like... I don't know. I think like Let Me Love You was a song I officially became a Justin Bieber fan. It was so cool to see him give attention. I respect Justin Bieber for this song so much. Let Me Love You is kind of a song that's like, you know, he didn't have to be on this album. As big as he is, he didn't have to be on this. You know, the fact that he gave attention to DJ Snake like this, I have mad respect for Justin Bieber after this song. Like, after this, I'm like, yeah, Justin Bieber's awesome. You know, because he didn't have to do this. Like, he didn't have to be on that song. He just chose to be. And that's cool. Like, I don't know how, like I said, I don't understand how DJ Snake got all of these people on this one album, but it is, you know, Justin Bieber was the craziest one. I couldn't even believe he got Justin Bieber, the biggest singer in the world, to be on this song. I don't know how he did it. Like, what did he say to him to do this? Like, bro. I know technically Justin Bieber's not as big anymore. Like, yeah, I guess Weeknd is technically bigger, maybe. Nah, but they're about the same on status. But like, I'm just saying, Justin Bieber's a huge, like, pop artist. I don't know how he got him on here. Like, granted, and let me tell you, Let Me Love You turned out perfectly. It is a freaking flawless song, in my opinion. I mean, lyrically, it's deep. Justin Bieber sings incredibly well. Probably the best vocal performance of his entire career. And DJ Snake just has some powerful, booming music in the background. I'll play a little bit. You've already heard it, but I'll play a little bit. Yeah, I used to believe... Don't fall asleep. I mean, it's a pretty iconic song. Like, I wouldn't say it's top 10, maybe top 10 DJ Snake songs. I love Let Me Love You a lot. It's truly an iconic song, truly phenomenal collab. I mean, it is just badass. Like, love it to death. But okay, I think I've wasted enough time. Time to dedicate this last part to the final song. This is the song I'm going to talk about the most of all the songs. So, I will, of course, I already said I'm going to talk about the last two, obviously, the bonus ones. I have the Target edition, so there's two bonus tracks I'm going to cover too. But anyway, so we made it. The end of the album. The final track. Simply titled Here Comes the Night. There's no light.
There's no light. No light in the sky. And it gets so cold.
honestly, at that point of the album, I burst into fucking tears, man. Like, that was... This is one of the greatest songs ever made. This is the greatest ending song to any album. Here Comes the Night. Like... Now, it's not my favorite. It's my second favorite DJ Snake song. But, god dang. Like... At that point, I gave it a 10. Instantly. As soon as I was finishing Encore, it was 10 out of 10. Favorite album of all time. Like... I was already pretty sure, but that kind of confirmed it. Like... Here Comes the Night. Like... I'd argue this is the most epic song. I mean... It is just a perfect ending to this freaking masterpiece of an album. Like... I mean, it just wrapped up completely well. And like I said, I'm going to get to the other two in a sec. The other two songs are really good bonus tracks. But, yeah, as an ending song, it was perfect. It just kind of wrapped it up in such a perfect way. It was epic, grand, beautiful. Send it off. DJ Snake just knows how to make an album. Like, as an album creator, the two albums he made were two of the best I've ever heard in my life. They are truly... He's just a phenomenal artist. A phenomenal music artist. Like, yeah, Here Comes the Night. Like, again, like I've said with the previous songs. This has the best lyrics of all the songs. Like, I'll read through them real quick. But, lyrically, it's probably his best song. Nice, you know you like it. Of course, this is the song he wrote. Everything looks old and tired when she leaves my side. I'll bite my tongue until that fucker bleeds. Yeah, I know, I can be alright. See, you set my sun, so here comes the night. Boss. Mr. Hudson's easily my second favorite singer of all time. I listen to his other... he's made three albums. I listened to his... I didn't listen to his very first one with his band, but I listened to the two solo ones he did. They're both phenomenally made albums. He's up there with The Weeknd. I can't put him above The Weeknd just because Weeknd's, like, more experienced and he has a better voice. I mean, they're both extremely close. Like, he made this, like... Two of my favorite songs are, like, Paranoid by Kanye West, which is... he's also on that in this one. Mr. Hudson just... man, this is one of the coolest, most dope collabs. Like, you know, like I said, Here Comes the Night's one of the best songs ever made. It is a phenomenal ending track. Just wraps it up perfectly. Summarizes how grand of a big deal this was. And you'll want an encore. So, yep. Okay. That was Encore by DJ Snake. Well, the main tracks. I'm gonna cover the two bonus ones here. Okay, I'll briefly cover them before I get into more discussion. But so True Love, I'm not gonna play them. You just have to look them up. True Love's really good. Really dope track. I love it a lot. 9 out of 10. True Love's dope. This is the only other song besides Propaganda where it's just DJ Snake. It's really fucking cool. But I think he took some samples of other stuff to make it, I think, from Lady Gaga. I'm not sure, because there is a little vocals in it. But yeah, it's an extremely well-done song. I kind of wish we had a lyric version of it. You know, it's a very underrated DJ Snake song. I really wish we got a voice version of it with people on it. That'd be cool. But, okay. And then the final track, the second bonus track. So, I mean, I've already told you, you know you like it. It's my favorite song. So, yeah. You Know You Like It is the final bonus track, but with the twist. So, it's not just You Know You Like It. It's also got the one and only DJ Premier. So guys, a little backstory here. DJ Premier was a huge inspiration. That fucking DJ Premier were huge inspirations for DJ Snake. So this must have been a humongous deal to have DJ Premier remix that you know you like it for. Like, it must have been a huge deal to him. Because he DJ Snake admired DJ Premier for a long time. Like, he thought he was one of the GOATs. So having him on it and remixing my favorite DJ Snake song was the coolest shit. Like, I couldn't believe it. It's such a great remix. It's probably one of my favorites. Well, weirdly enough, you know you like it. The song is already a remix of the Luna George song, technically. But even though Luna George gave credit, it's technically a collab. But yeah, you know what I mean. So the remix of You Know You Like It is awesome. It's really well done. I'm not going to play it. You can just look it up. But yeah, it's awesome. Truly a epic epilogue. I don't know which one's... They're both great ending tracks. Here Comes Yankee, You Know You Like It, DJ Premier remix. They're both excellent ending tracks. But yeah, that's what I'm saying. But okay, so that's every song. That's the whole album. That's Encore. Well, why do I have to give a rating? You already know what it is. Encore is a masterpiece. Yeah, no shit. I mean, it's 10 out of 10. Duh. Obviously. Of course. What else would it be? Like, bro. It's Encore. It's DJ Snake's Encore. Like, I wouldn't say this is objectively the best. Really, there is no objective best album ever made. If I were to say what the objectively best album ever made, I guess it would be technically, like, Meteora or, like, My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy. Like, production-wise, I guess those are better than my DJ Snake albums I love so much. But as a personal lever, look, think about it. Without Encore, I don't think I'd be into music as much as I am. This album really changed my entire perception of music. Like, DJ Snake's my the biggest inspiration to me. Like, this one album changed my entire life. Like, I went from liking music to admiring it to an extreme degree. Like, he made me realize how powerful music can be. That's how powerful this album was to me. It changed my entire life. From this point on, I pretty much have always checked out new albums. I've always checked out music. I've always given new artists a chance. I always check new stuff out now. Because DJ Snake took a bunch of people that weren't well known. Like, excluding Justin Bieber and Mr. Hudson. And, of course, the Half People. Okay, there was a few famous people on here, obviously, but I'm saying a lot of the album doesn't have famous people. Like, he took a bunch of not famous people and made some kick-ass songs. Like, I don't know. It's just, it's truly inspirational. It blows my, every time there's an encore, I'm blown by it. It's never gonna go down for me as my favorite album. It would take something crazy. Like, not even Carte Blanche. As amazing as Carte Blanche was, not even that could top this first album for me. Like, now, maybe his third album could. I don't know. I have yet to listen to an album I love more than Encore. Like, for real. I've yet to listen to one. I don't think it's possible for me to like an album more than Encore, because it's just so personally and driven. It's such a personal part of my life. This album really just means more to me than anything. Like, any piece of music. It changed my entire life. Like, I like to reiterate, you know, a lot of albums I wouldn't even checked out. Like, I didn't listen, like I said, before Encore, I only listened to, like, two or three albums before. And the Eminem ones. Like I'm saying, I only listened to a couple Eminem albums, a couple Kanye records, and some couple Linkin Park albums. That was it. That was the only albums I listened to. But not anymore. Thanks to Encore, all these other 10 out of 10 albums I have on my list are there. Because I listened to this first. This album literally changed my entire perception on music. Like, I wasn't a big music person before that. Like, yeah, I listened to Kanye, Linkin Park, and a couple Big Sean and a couple other things. There was a couple things I listened to. But I wasn't, like, super into album listening. Like, I didn't give a shit about albums. You know. Until I listened to Encore. Then I realized, well, fuck. I mean, albums can be amazing. They can be amazing. Holy shit. Like, music's amazing. It's really amazing. Thank you, DJ Snake. If I met DJ Snake in person, I mean, I want to meet him in person one day. I really want to just be like, you changed my life, man. You really touched me on a spiritual level. Like, there's never going to be a fan of DJ Snake bigger than me. If you exist, come meet me. Because I've yet to meet someone that loves DJ Snake as much as I do. Nobody does. It's literally impossible. Like I said, this is literally my favorite album. Nobody can compete with that. Nobody has Encore as their favorite album besides me. Like, that's literally it. Nobody does. I don't think I'm yet to meet one that has this as their favorite album. Because I am the biggest DJ Snake fan in the world. I love him to death. Every song he makes is freaking almost flawless. He never messes up. He gives it 110%. The people he collabs with are amazing. Okay, you get it. I'm just ranting at this point. I'm just ranting at this point, but yeah. So, DJ Snake's Encore. Truly the best album ever made, in my opinion. It is fucking perfect. It is fucking perfect. Yes, Meteor is amazing too. Those are all masterpieces. Mez Education, Illmatic, all those are amazing. But, man, Encore is one of a kind. Changed my entire life. Truly my favorite album of all time. Happy 5-year anniversary, DJ Snake. You deserve all the praise and recognition you get. You are truly a perfect, inspirational, epic musician. And I hope you continue making music because, man, I don't even want to imagine a world where there's no DJ Snake music. Like, for real. I mean, for fucks, like, for real. I love this man so much. All right. You get it. I think you understand. You get the point. I'm going on for an hour. So, alright. Thank you all for watching. And, check out my next video, upcoming videos, whenever they come out. Chain of Meisters, signing out. Bitch on your stony, I do it all. Candy paint with the white on top. Lambo doors or the woo up drop. If you busy plotting on what I got, kicking your door and swat you thought. $100,000 on the tabletop. Have price my whips.